Temple Arch, Bayswater Road.
Each time
Hindus may kill Christians there, but they don't say it, you can't think.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Speaker's Corner London. It's not much, we know, but it is what is left of a tradition that was hard won in the 19th century after various groups of malcontents came here and displayed their anger and the resentment at the conditions, government policies. So nothing's changed, you see. But hard won, as I say, and this is what's left of it. Maybe we don't value our freedom of speech. This, I've said before, is the last ditch of the Greek ideal of the freedom of speech. Maybe we take for granted our alleged democracy. Maybe. But it could be, of course, everyone's at that other venue, Trafalgar Square, expressing their unrest, their malcontent, their resentment that there's been 10 years of war in Afghanistan, the high dusty places of Afghanistan, which most of us will only ever see on TV. And TV, of course, is not really, just like the other media, is not really there to inform us. Television is a medium of powerful control. Perhaps these people here represent television. Whatever they shoot, of course, whatever is broadcast, that will be made by other people, those decisions. Who is it that's decided that on Sky News there's no pictures of the protests in Trafalgar Square? Who is it who's decided that there's no pictures, no images or interviews with the protesters at Trafalgar Square? I saw online on the net, and thank God for the internet, I saw online the claim, which may be extravagant, might be true, that Noam Chomsky, no less, is going to be speaking at Trafalgar Square today. I've decided to forego that experience to come and talk to you, good people. Noam Chomsky, of course, has been a long-time critic of American foreign policy. I guess Afghanistan is sufficiently far away from Israel and Israeli interests not to bother Noam Chomsky. But even Noam Chomsky has said, it's on record, it's on tape, it's on the net, has said, who cares about 9/11, who cares who did it? What's to that effect? The invasion of Afghanistan, 10 years, all those deaths, not just of the armed forces of this country, and particularly the United States of America, other places, the so-called heroes. Surely the real heroes are the soldiers who refuse to go, who refuse to kill strangers, so that an oil pipeline can be laid. Because that was the Taliban's real crime, their real sin. They reneged, they backed out of an oil pipeline agreement. That's what happened. 9/11 was convenient because it allowed Uncle Sam to rove over this planet to see what else he could plunder and steal in his empire of greed. Of course, the British used to have their own empire of greed. Uncle Sam has taken over that role. The British, slightly resentful, Tony Blair on the coattails of George W.
And Gaddafi.
Gaddafi, Colonel Gaddafi, what was his sin? What did Colonel Gaddafi really do? Why did he attack Colonel Gaddafi? Was it because of the excellent health service? No. Was it because of the excellent roads he built with oil revenues? No. Was it because of that marvellous engineering feat where he irrigated the desert? No. It's because he no longer wanted to sell his oil, his black gold, for US dollars, which he could see was going down the toilet. As the troops are still up there in Afghanistan, they're not really fighting the Taliban. That might have been true a long time ago. The Taliban have grown, because as the drones have recklessly killed other people, so resentment has grown, enemies have augmented the Taliban, entire wedding parties have been wiped out so they could kill one particular a member of the Taliban. The Soviet experience was different because the Soviets were up against the entire Afghanistan. NATO, the US really, is up against a part of Afghanistan, and I'm not a student of military science, but people who allegedly know about these things, they all have a broad consensus, which is that the war in Afghanistan is unwinnable. It cannot be won. So why have another soldier die? For what? For oil? For mineral resources? At least tell these men the truth about why they're sacrificing their lives, why they're dying. Don't give them some highfalutin bullshit about human rights or democracy. The US has a travesty of democracy. The same financial powers control both the main parties. Ideally, they like to have the Republican nominee and their Democratic nominee in their back pocket. It would be nice if someone could break the mold, such as the Republican nominee, Ron Paul. Already CBS, a major news outlet, one of the top American networks, is putting it out there that Ron Paul, who won a straw poll, well, the ballot boxes were scuffed. You see, associate Ron Paul with electoral fraud. What a joke. How do you think George W. Bush got to be president twice? An election stolen in Florida, the later election stolen, 4 years later, stolen in Ohio with doctored machines. Online, on record, the man who wrote the software code for these machines, who's admitted that the code's written to rig the election, is not well known. He's not on our TVs. TV is largely a medium of control. It's not there to enlighten you. It's not there to inform you. You will have to take responsibility for that yourself. Why is it, as I said earlier, why is it that on Sky News, on the competing BBC News 24, there's no mention of there's no footage of the protest today at Trafalgar Square against 10 years of war? If I could speak to these young men in uniform, which is highly improbable, I'd say, look son, don't light your soul for a queen or even a country. And by the way, which part of this country? Show me a few acres or even a square foot of it that's your style. His country. It's all been bought up long ago. It's owned by aristocratic families, and how did they acquire it?
By theft and robbery, Mr. Speaker.
Yes, Mr. Speaker, exactly. By the way, we've just lost a remarkable man, great visionary, probably an E.T., Stephen Paul Jobs.
And he's Aquarius, Mr. Speaker.
He died this week.
In spirit now.
Friend of Apple. He'll maybe be going back to his home planet. Maybe he'll come back. Maybe he'll return through the walk-in process. Because we've a long way to go. The technology is helping to liberate us, to free us. The internet, which they hate because they can't shut it down, they hate because they can't control it, it's your best friend. Of course, be aware that everything you look at on the web is known and recorded. But the more people use this facility, the more futile it becomes for the controllers. September 11th, 2001, the collapse of the World Trade Center was the beginning of the end of the capitalist system. Good riddance. You think Hyde would be cheering. You think the Marxist-Leninists would be celebrating the end of capitalism. But if capitalism was really great, what would he complain about? Well, Nicholas's complaint, my complaint, or a real complaint, I think, Nicky, correct me if I'm wrong, is that you don't inform yourself.
You're right, Huey.
You empower yourself. We come and say the most outrageous things. I resent this division of humankind in the Jew and Gentile, black and white. This polarisation that sets us at each other's throats. These artificial divisions of country and trade and religion, political fear, economic fear. All this stuff sets us at each other's throats. And we never spend the time. We're so busy shoring up our own side, our own tribe, our own nation. We never see that We're in this together. There seems to be a dispute between a coalition government led by Prime Minister David Cameron and the police. The police have been caught taking money from the Murdoch media empire. Caught red-handed. Exposed. So an investigation had to be undertaken. Of course, the cutbacks, we're all in this together, have to affect the police. They don't want cutbacks. They want more personnel, more powers. So we had the riots starting in Tottenham, where the police ambushed a so-called gangster. Even if he's a gangster, we have to due process the law. There's a proper way to do things. There's been a number of these extrajudicial murders. The gangster in Tottenham, John Charles de Menezes. If I could apologise to all the people of Brazil, I would. I'd say we're very, very sorry what happened to your son on our soil. That was a disgrace. Well, we thought you had the bomb. Does that mean the police can think that you, any one of you's got a bomb? And they can empty a gun in your head and get away with it? If that isn't a definition of a police state, I don't know what is. There's a man shot down by the police carrying a table leg. They thought it might be a gun. We'll find out. Don't determine what it is. In fact, a table leg. Just gun him down. Get away with it. These police have watched too many episodes of US cop shows.
Yeah.
What's the answer, my friend?
The answer is you. Informing yourself, empowering yourself, speaking to your creator and asking, how can I be of service?
Speaking to who?
Your creator.
Okay. Who is my creator?
Good question. I'm not. You and I share the same creator.
Right, which one? If I listen to these guys here, it could be Allah, it could be Jesus, it could be...
No, I said...
Somebody's talking about coming from a monkey.
Moses was a prophet. I said the creator.
The creator.
The creator. The source. Everything comes from one source. I saw an edition of Horizon. We're talking now about dark flow. Before that, the buzzwords were dark energy. Dark matter. They have to invent this shit to make the equations fit. The universe is not without consciousness. It's not empty. Every art, Alice Bailey, one of her books is called The Consciousness of the Atom. Christ Jesus, when he came back to Jerusalem for that final difficult week, he said, we're trying to shut the kids up because the children and their souls knew who he was. Shut the kids up. Jesus said, if you shut the kids up, the very stones will cry out. Science is so ignorant, so backward, and yet so arrogant. Look at the medical profession. Who gave Steve Jobs, co-founder of Apple, immunosuppressant drugs because he had a liver transplant. Look how backward their medicine is. And yet they oppose Obama, who tries to reform it. Or indeed, Mitt Romney in his home state. Your health needs to be your concern, and you need to take responsibility for it. If you go to the medical profession, they've got a fat job, fat salary, and you know, the prefix doctor. That keeps them seduced. And they serve, wittingly or unwittingly, pharmaceutical giants, huge drug interests. People saying Steve Jobs left his money to cancer research. Are you kidding? Have you an idea how much money has been given to cancer research? The world's biggest scam is banking, the world's second biggest scam, cancer research. Steve Jobs left an alleged fortune of $6.7 billion. Sounds a lot, doesn't it? But chemotherapy, one of the three standard treatments for cancer, makes in $40 billion a year worldwide. Do you think they want a cure for cancer when they're making so much money? Lots of people suffering. Let's see what time it is on my wonderful iPhone. The original iPhone. 5:23 p.m. I wonder if BBC News 24 or Sky has yet showed the protest today at Trafalgar Square. I feel like I'm probably missing something. Nicholas was there last night, he said. Soaking up the vibe, maybe dropping in a few angels, who knows what. This is a battlefield. This is a great time of resolution. The end of the age of Pisces, the beginning of the new age of Aquarius. This new age isn't going to just be another new age. It's going to be in that time, the next 2,000 year time frame, there'll be a golden age. These golden ages have happened before and they'll happen again. And in the golden age, of course, there won't be all this warfare. But meanwhile, you know, the United Kingdom tries to balance his books by selling arms. There's a new scandal with Dr. Liam Fox outselling arms. Why are we doing this? How can we have peace in the world when we've got all these arms dealers out there, politicians? We never elected them to sell arms to Arab nations or anywhere else. And then, of course, we've got our friends in the CIA fomenting trouble in Tripoli, as they did in Libya. Somebody said on the internet, Libya's been a CIA project for 30 years. Assad of Syria says it's foreign causing the trouble in Syria. Same now in Saudi Arabia. You know, we're supposed to be celebrating this Arab Spring this year and the rising up of people against tyranny. But what kind of tyranny is it that on our television doesn't show us the protests in America, in the United States? Have you seen any of the stuff of Occupy Wall Street on the BBC? Horse guy. Isn't that news? Which is more news, that a third of Americans are occupying Wall Street, that the protests have spread to other US cities, or that Paul McCartney's getting married again? Now, I wish Paul McCartney well. I hope him and his wealthy lady will be happy ever after.
Listen, we just love you.
What we're trying to marry, me and Nicholas, is truth and passion.
What is the truth?
The truth is that all across this earth, elites have arisen. People have, crafty people have thought, these people are suckers, I could take advantage of them. And they run industry, they run banking, the pharmaceutical, that's the drugs companies, education. Every area we look at is poisoned by these particular people. And the education system is just like sort of, you know, to keep the whole scam going. That's largely what it is. It's a rare individual who can throw off the programming. And when a doctor like Gawain was speaking about Andrew Wakefield and the MMR vaccine, even today there are vast numbers of people who want to trash Andrew Wakefield and the MMR vaccine, not considering the potential shock to any child's immune system of these three agents in one go. Why do they have MMR? The brutal, ugly truth is because it's cheaper, it's more economic for one visit to the highly paid GP than it is for individual vaccinations. And as Gawain said earlier, when the Prime Minister of the day, Tony Blair, was asked whether his child was vaccinated with the MMR, he declined to answer. Isn't that marvellous? They want to cut down the population of the earth. If you heard the phrase, the useless eaters, that comes from eugenics. And that is sourced to one of the friends of Charles Darwin, secular saint Charles Darwin, upheld by Professor Richard Dawkins. All of this didn't come from nothing. People say, yeah, but if it come from God, where did God come from? God's always been. God's eternal, but the universe isn't eternal. The universe exists, it lives for a very, very long time.
Mr. Speaker, science says the universe will implode in billions of years' time.
The scientists who say that, Nick, believe that they didn't exist before they were born or conceived. They believe that when they die, they'll cease to exist.
Which is, of course, wrong.
Right? So you get someone who believes that they have one little life on this planet.
And that's it.
As this gentleman knows, we have many lives.
Yeah. the secrets of Hinduism.
Mr. Speaker, I have a question.
Okay, I'll try and answer.
What is the difference between plutocrats and democrats?
Plutocrats are people who govern by virtue of the wealth. The idea is the wealth they should govern because there's only get them the most to lose, or them to the most invested in a working civilization of society, right? Democrats can be disparagingly regarded as mob rule, or it's the sort of collective will of the people.
How can you neutralize the plutocrats? Because they are ruining the world.
Oh yeah, I don't think you can neutralize them. I don't think you need to neutralize them. I don't advocate any kind of violence against anyone.
How can you deactivate
them? Well, what happens is the mechanism, which is greed, eventually consumes itself. It's like the debt crisis. The debt has been so big, we can't get at the underlying principle. Then it becomes so big, we can't even pay the interest on the principle.
How can you get it back?
Well, I would say take your money out and invest, put it into things that are tangible, like land, gold, or other precious silver. No, I'm not doing these things, you might not, but we can't say we weren't told what to do. Because all the channel sources I'm reading, Nikki's very skeptical of these things, that's fair enough, but all the channel stuff I'm reading is saying that we're going to have global economic collapse, you know, and it's already happening. It really is happening already. I mean, you can see the politicians, they're turning each other. President Obama was in Europe trying to get the Europeans to, he said he knows that if the euro collapses, that's going to affect the US, and so we're all tied up together. It's called globalization. So that means you've got a domino effect. If one goes, they all go. The major currency, certainly. The US and China have been in conflict for some time over trade. See, there's been fears, prophecies of China and the US going to war. Did you know that China, both China and Russia have contracts with Iran that need to be honored? Do you know that both China and Russia have got an agreement with the Republic of Iran? You know that? See? Why do you think Israel hasn't already attacked Iran? You could say, well, President Obama and President Bush are both restrained of Israel, which they have. But for how long?
Huey, can I interject? Apparently, and I learned this recently, certain of the hawks in the White House wanted Bush to attack Syria during his government. Really? And George W. said no.
Conspiracy theory holds the view that the President, the Prime Minister, the Premier and so forth isn't really in charge. The people who we think run the world don't actually run the world. They're just middle management. They're just local branch managers for NWO Incorporated, the New World Order. But the New World Order, that my poster there, which I took from a television documentary, have a shot of that, Nikki. It's ambiguous.
Actually, it should be New World Disorder.
We're against the New World Order.
We are living in New World Disorder.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Right? But it also means there won't be a New World Order. It's collapsing, it's falling apart.
Now, this New World does not mean... Is there a way we can get rid of this New World Order? Actually, New World Disorder.
Yes. We don't need to. It just collapses under the weight of its own feet.
Okay.
What takes its place is a time of social
unrest,
disorder, a kind of anarchy, the worst kind of anarchy.
The worst part of capitalism.
Yeah.
Out of that, people will organize locally, like the people who, like the sick men who organize themselves to protect their place of worship. So people will organize and build up, and in fact, already parachuted in amongst us are financial wizards like our friend David. He's already here, and he's not unique. He's a special guy, but there's others like him. They're just quietly among. You know, there's ETs here. There are extraterrestrials on this planet walking around in human bodies. Thousands of them.
Yes, absolutely. It's true.
Right? So it's a wonderful time to be alive. It's an exciting time.
Yes, Mr.
It's a
Speaker.
Curse. May you live in interesting times. And may your God go with you. Thank you for listening, ladies and gentlemen. God bless you.